Fusion 360 used to limit mesh files to 50,000 facets, or the triangles that make up the file. As of July 2021, there is no longer a limit to mesh facets other than how much your computer hardware can handle. This, along with many other mesh enhancements, makes it easier than ever to insert, fix, and alter 3D scans in Fusion 360. The workflows covered in this lesson will also work for other STL or OBJ mesh files that you find online. I've scanned this 3D bust using the Revopoint POP scanner. Now, their software has room for improvement, but at only $550, this scanner works extremely well, especially for its size and portability. To follow along, you can also download the 3D scan demo file below this video. In Fusion 360, we'll start by heading to the Mesh tab. From here, we can go to the Insert dropdown and select Insert Mesh. After selecting the OBJ or STL file, be sure to define the unit type. STL and OBJ files are unitless, so you must select the correct unit. We can hit the flip up direction to rotate the model if it needs to be reoriented. If the model disappears, simply select the home icon next to the view cube to recenter the model. Let's click OK to confirm the placement. Notice that Insert Mesh is now recorded in the parametric timeline. Before we do anything else, take a moment to revolve the model around. You will notice with this particular 3D scan, there's a large hole in the bottom. Openings in 3D scans and mesh files in general are a common problem. Fortunately, this is an easy fix in Fusion 360, and we have many additional tools to utilize. For starters, I'll toggle open the Bodies folder in the browser. Fusion 360 will now provide a warning for mesh files that are not fully closed. Hovering over the warning will provide the message that mesh is not closed and mesh does not have a positive volume. In our case, we already were aware of the hole. However, keep an eye out for this warning in the browser, as many mesh models will contain small holes that are hard to catch. Selecting the warning icon will open up the new repair feature. Repair can also be activated in the mesh toolbar or the prepare dropdown. With our mesh body selected, we need to select one of the four repair types. Close hole is the fastest option and will make the fewest number of changes to the mesh body. This will attempt to flip triangles and close any openings. Stitch and remove will make the same changes as close holes and also stitch triangles, remove double triangles, removes degenerate faces, and removes tiny shells. In essence, it will clean up and remove any unnecessary facets. Wrap makes the same changes as stitch and remove while also wrapping the surface of the mesh body. All the inner structures are destroyed. This process takes an average amount of time compared to the rest. Lastly, the slowest method is rebuild. This option will reconstruct the mesh body using one of the four rebuild types. Any inner structures will be destroyed. Mesh files vary greatly, and there are many variables, so you'll find that some experimenting is often needed. Let's start with the fastest option, close holes. After clicking OK, you will find that the mesh body is now closed off on the bottom. To 3D print this, I'd like to remove the bottom half of the 3D bust. This can easily be done with the plane cut command. Select the mesh body followed by the plane to use as a cutting tool. In many cases, you can use one of the origin planes. However, you can also use any construction plane. We can then use the directional arrows and rotation sliders to manipulate the position of the cut. Depending on the desired cut, this may take some time to adjust. The flip icon will flip the side of the mesh body if you need to cut in the other direction. If you would like to simply split your mesh body into two 3D bodies, we can change the type from trim to split body. Alternatively, split faces will split the faces while keeping a single 3D body. Take note that our fill type defaults to no fill. Let's click OK to take a look at the results. You'll notice that we once again have a warning in the browser as our mesh has an opening at the bottom. This would be OK if we were to stitch the mesh to another. Instead, let's double click on the plane cut feature in the timeline to change the fill type to minimal. This will seal off the bottom with the fewest amount of faces, which is perfect for this use case since we know we have a flat surface. Uniform will use the same number of facets throughout the new surface. After clicking OK, you'll see that we once again have a fully closed mesh body. to 3D print this bust would use a fair amount of filament on the inside. Fortunately, we could utilize the new mesh features, including the shell command. The mesh shell command works just like the solid modeling shell command, hollowing out our model per the defined thickness. Using the section analysis tool, you'll find this hollowed out the model based on the defined thickness. This mesh shell command is extremely powerful, as you no longer need to convert your mesh to a solid body just to use the shell command. It will also perform better on complex shapes where the solid shell command could not compute. You'll also find the combine command is now available as a mesh tool. This, along with Tessellate, opens up a brand new workflow. In many cases, you may find it helpful to create a solid object, convert it to a mesh, and then combine or work with the mesh bodies in Fusion 360 instead of the need to convert your mesh to a solid body. Let's flip to the Solid tab and sketch out a simple base to place the 3D bust on. We can then extrude this with the Solid Extrude command, resulting in a solid 3D body. Back in the Mesh tab, we can use the Tessellate feature to convert an existing solid or surface body into a mesh body. Notice this gives us many refinement settings to fine-tune the mesh. Remember that you can always edit the feature in the timeline to adjust the settings. The Create Quads option can be checked if you would like four-sided faces. Though, note this will only happen where possible on the mesh body. This will allow you to convert a mesh body with quad faces directly to a T-spline body. After clicking OK, you'll see that our solid body was turned into a mesh. You may have also noticed that this body has many different colors on each side. These pastel colors represent the face groups. Face groups help you and the software better understand where mesh facets lie on the same plane. It's important to note that the face groups are required to convert a mesh to a solid body using the prismatic option, as covered in my other lesson. Face group creation is also less effective on complex models, such as 3D scans, versus objects that were created directly in a CAD program. Alignment of mesh bodies is one of the current limitations of working with meshes in Fusion 360. There's unfortunately not yet a way to easily align these two meshes, but we can still utilize the Move command to position this 3D bust. After spending some time to move it into position, we can use the Combine feature. Combine is as simple as selecting two or more mesh bodies, followed by choosing the operation. In this case, we'd like to join, but note that you can intersect, cut, or merge. Merge will combine the bodies and preserve internal structures, while join will merge the two bodies. If you recall, we previously shelled the 3D bust. Because mesh is parametric, we can now drag the mesh shell command to the end of our timeline. This will ensure the shell thickness is applied to the entire 3D body, including the base. Another current limitation is that there are no fillets or chamfers with mesh tools, so keep that in mind. We could always roll back the timeline and apply a fillet on these edges before it's converted to a mesh. Lastly, we can right-click on the mesh body and select Save as Mesh, which was formerly called Save as STL. This was renamed because Save as Mesh now includes the .3mf file extension. 3mf is a mesh file similar to STL files, however, it also includes additional information such as unit of measurement. This means you can open it in another program without having to worry about the correct unit of measure. The two Save as STL options are nearly identical, but the binary option will be a much smaller file size without distorting the model. With that in mind, I recommend using the binary option. To summarize, Fusion 360's new mesh tools allow you to insert, repair, and alter 3D scans and other large mesh files. There are many new workflows using the mesh tools, and you no longer need to convert every mesh to a solid body. Special thanks to the new patrons and those who supported the channel via my Buy Me a Coffee page. Be sure to check out productdesignonline.com for our premium step-by-step courses and additional Fusion 360 content. And subscribe right here on YouTube to enjoy more free lessons.